where it will be. And so we'll be covering SEO today. If you could see, this is the front end of the site. This is one of the page. These are few posts, blogs, which you could say. This was same like a page where you can add content. You can put photograph, you can have anchor text. We'll just cover everything side by side today also, when we're gonna cover search engine optimization. Now since this site has been made on a backend, on a CMS called WordPress, we could check out its backend too. Once you enroll into the course, I've been told that you'll be given one site each, so you'll also get this kind of website. Password. Wait. Forgot the password. Does anyone of you have a website on CMS on this WordPress? Anto, do you have that? Okay, we're connected. Anyway, I got the password. No, it's okay. So I got the password. Not required now. Now if you could see here, this is the front end of the site. Yeah. And this is its back end. So you can change themes while coming over here in this section, appearances and themes. By default you get a theme called 2016, but you can then change theme according to how you want to build a site. And I selected one of the other themes which I find was okay for my kind of website which I wanted. And you can just go and select post over here, right, and select the post and add a new post if in case you want to do that. I'm just with one line referring you know how to add the content on the website, and then we'll see if a content has been added, how we are going to optimize it, right? So you can just add a title over here of the post, and then you can just write down whatever you want to write, like this is my first class and something like that and all that. Right. You can just write the content, add a few attachments in case you want to add a, for example, Anto is one of the batch. Matchmates here, and then you can select Anto, and if in case you want to give an external link to, let's say, Anto's website. I don't know if he has right now he doesn't have it yet, but he'll soon gonna get it. So let's say if it is anto.com, so it can just select it and add link. So this is a few things which you can play around the content. Once it is done, you have to make it visible for search engine for a given search for any few keywords you want this page to come up on the top. Now that is the objective of search engine optimization, right? So since you guys are not familiar with how to put a content on a CMS, I've just given a few glimpse on that. So that is, we have already covered this kind of topic in the last sessions. So let us cover now search engine optimization. Now search engine optimization is basically, there are two ways a query responds in a search. If you go to a Google page and let's say you want to buy name me any product which you're looking to buy or you're looking to inquire about it. Friends, just name me one such product. Laptop is, as soon as you put laptop over here, you could see that you get these kinds of results. Now for all who are already there into the sessions know how you define this SERP search engine result page and divide it into various subsections. But those who are there for the first time, there are two kind of results which you're getting. You could see that on the top, this is, it's a sponsored link, as in it's an ad. It has been paid specifically and differently, separately for the result to publish over here. So it is not a part of search engine optimization. It's not an organic result which has come. It is a paid result which has come. So there are two type of results, a paid result and a non-paid result. Or a non-paid result is also called organic result or a part of SEO. Whereas paid result is basically using Google AdWords as a tool and letting Google know that I'm ready to pay this amount. If somebody search for laptop, you please bring my query onto the top. So that if somebody clicks on that, I'm ready to pay you a certain amount. That is called CPC, a click per, a cost per click rate, right? Now we'll cover that in detail once we go forward. But since we are covering SEO today, this is just to give you a glimpse what this is. That now, in once you go to Google AdWords, you can put an ad in four to five different formats. This is the shopping format. And this is the keyword based format, a normal keyword based format, and you could see an ad written over here. So for here, HP shopping or Dell.com is paying separately for this keyword. If somebody search for that, they are paying separately to Google for the result to come onto the top, so that the user, you know, they're putting it on the top, on the front, so that user can click on that and land to their site. So they're ready to pay separately. It can range from anything between, depending upon the bidding option, it can range from 4-5 rupees per click to, let's say, 40 rupees, 50 rupees per click, depending upon what kind of competition is there in the keyword. We'll cover that once we cover Google AdWords. But if you see over here, Amazon.in or this Snap deal result or this Wikipedia result or this MySmartPrice.com result, these are the basic ascent, these are the organic results. So what is the job of Google? Basically, job of Google is that if you search something, it has to show you the results, what it feels are the best suitable related for your the search which you're making, what is there in your mind, and you're just putting a search. So this is their main product and this is their main relevance for the product. So what happens is, out of various web pages scrolling around in the world, when somebody writes down a query, the search engine starts making search on its directory and pick up these results. And there is an algorithm where on top it will show the results for the ad-based paid results and then the non-paid results. Now, what are we doing as a search engine optimizer over here, or a digital marketer who is practicing search engine optimization, is we are making our page so much efficient that when it's been searched for that kind of focal keyword, we want it to be on the top. Now, this requires a hell lot of hard work on page as well as off page. We'll cover what is on page, what is off page. And we are making it so popular, so efficient. So there are two grounds in which we make our web pages such, result oriented, that search engine picks it up, and it requires a great amount of effort and number of days and number of months in order to achieve that. So there are two things which we do. A, we make it efficient, and B, we make it popular. What are the two ways, basic ways? I'm just trying to define it in very layman terms. By means of efficiency, I mean that it should be such efficient within its content that it becomes very easy for search engine to pick you as a page related to the focal keyword which you have picked. And that is called on-page optimization. Let's consider this example metaphorically and not literally today. Metaphorically, if you go to any showroom, you see that whatever you're doing inside the showroom, it's kind of on-page optimization. So whatever you're doing on the page, you're doing it as an on-page optimization. So you are improving its content, you are putting meta title related to your focal keyword, or you're putting meta description related to your focal keyword, and there are various other attributes, small and big, which you kind of function on the page, on the website. That is called on-page optimization. And off-page optimization is, let's say, for example, you're roaming around in a mall and you see various signages which are directing you or somehow mentioning your name, your showroom name into that. So if I'm on a search and I see there are various websites who are giving my website as a backlink. So if I, let's say, go to, for example, I go to nikhilgrover.com, and over here I find a backlink to Santosh. So Santosh website is getting a backlink from nikhilgrover.com. In one way or the other, Santosh website is getting a higher vote, a higher weightage in terms of Google's eyes, that it is being getting popular to other sites as well. So it must be a good site related to that keyword. In a basic terminology, that is off-page optimization, because nothing has been done on Santosh's website. It's been done outside his domain of his website, which is nikhilgrover.com, which is a different website, right? So if anything will be done on a content which has been put on Santosh's website, that is called on-page optimization. And so we are going to cover on-page optimization today. Right? Clear till here? What is the basic difference between an on-page optimization and an off-page optimization? And what exactly is on-page optimization? Anto, Santosh, Krish. Alright, so first thing first, we are gonna work upon keywords now. Yes. So what happens is, let's take one e-commerce for example. So on the other batch we have, so I prefer taking examples which are known to us or amongst the group. So we have another batchmate. She has her own site, this pahadit.com. So if you see, she is selling her products on you know a different subcategory, like for example black tea, green tea, white tea and all that. Now let's say she want to promote black tea, and these are the, she are doing SEO for her website. For SEO you need to do SEO for different pages, right? And let's say she want to promote it this page right now. So if anybody search for black tea, she want her result to come on the top for this. So first she need to choose keywords. She need to choose what should be those keywords which I should target. And in order to choose those keywords, this will be very helpful not only in search engine optimization but also in paid ads. So the ground reality remains the same, that what are those keywords which are you making as a focal keyword and building up your search engine optimization around that. So you're doing every activity related to that keyword. Now keyword is that one center point. In order to have that, there are two, three suggested ways to do that. In order to select what could be the keyword for which I want my page as a resultant, could be coming out of your gut feel that you believe that these are the keywords I should be focusing around. But related to black tea, there could be 100 of keywords, right? Now in order how to select what is the response you're getting on each keyword, you could use the tool called keyword planner tool of Google, right? So for that, you need to have a Google AdWords account, and you can go to Google AdWords account. Just it is getting opened. We'll cover each and every mechanism of whatever you're looking into it once we cover Google AdWords. So don't get confused out of, you know, looking onto so many buttons and so many columns and so many stats coming out of here. Don't get confused out of it. It is very easy. But we'll cover that once we cover Google AdWords. Right now our idea is to get the efficiency of keywords. So you need to go to tools. I'm sorry. You need to go to tools. Once you click on tools, there will be a drop down, and there you need to go and select keyword planner, right? You select keyword planner. So navigation bar, there is tools, and then there is a drop down. You go to keyword planner. And here you get into the keyword planner thing. So before selecting what could be the keyword, there are two, three mechanisms you could play into the picture. The best is to go to your primary audience and ask what kind of keywords they look for. So first you could list down a few keywords into your mind. Then you can go and talk to prospective customers, filter it down to a level, and then to back it up with few stats and, you know, mixing gut feel with the science, you could use this keyword planner tool, right? So here you can put down, let's say for example I'm putting green tea. It is up to you, you want to put a landing page or not. Select a product category. sorry, my system is working a little slow today. And then you select your respective category out of it. So it's up to you, you want to select it or not. And then you select your target area. Let's say your targeting area is India. You can also localize, if in case you suppose you have opened a beauty salon which you only want to cater onto the local area. So you can select a local area targeting also. So it will reflect you what kind of search is happening onto your local area related to your keyword. And it suggests various other related keywords to you. So it's up to you what you want to do. Let's say I'm searching for all over India. And this is this. I can click on get ideas. And then you select keyword ideas. But just select it, you could see. This is the result which I got. Green tea benefits, people are searching with the name green tea benefits. Average monthly search is 14,800 times, you know. Suggested bid is growing 9.87, which is not related right now, which will be related once we'll do Google AdWords or paid advertisement format. And it's a medium competitive. Now here is a little debatable thing, but anyways, you can just first look down to various keywords over here. Now in order to synchronize it, there are 800 keywords right now. So in order to have it in front of you in an Excel, you can just click on to download. So it will ask you want in an Excel CSV format. I'll say yes. Click on download. And want to save it. I'll say yes. I want to save it. And you could see that these are the keywords, these are the suggested bids. This is something which I do not want right now. I can delete it. Not even this. So this is a high competition, 0.9, 0.63 is medium competition, 0.07 is low competition. Right. Now you have various keywords in front of you. Now what you can do is, for your website and for different web pages, you can select various keywords amongst it. Now on one hand, you have a website where, let's say this is the website and you have various other pages. Black is, you know, black tea is one page, green tea is one page, white tea is one page. Now the suggested way to do it is, you can do it either way. You can go by keyword and then selecting for this keyword what could be, you know, the page you will be doing it, but then it will become quite lengthy process. The better way is that you need to optimize your page. So you can just list down the page over here on the right hand side. Let's say, for example, I want to, right now my focus is, let's say, on green tea, for example. So this is one page. I can just copy the URL over here and paste. So I'll write down page URL as a heading. Right. I can wrap text this. I can select this. Now related to this URL, I want to select focus keywords. For one particular page, I suggest you to go with from one to three focal keywords. So over here, now it is your prerogative what kind of keyword you want to search. Related to green tea only, you will find various keywords, right? So amongst those various keywords, what kind of keyword you want, what kind of those 1, 2, or 3 keywords you want as a focal keyword, this is the call which you need to take right now, and it is quite subjective call. So what you can do is, for example, you can select about, so you can see what kind of benefits you'll get if you select these type of keywords. Since its number is quite high, 801 keywords, we need to filter it down, right? And let's say you filter it down, and this is what you got. Now amongst this, you need to choose it. So for this keyword, if I color mark it, let's say green color, I'll select from here what I want. Now it becomes quite subjective. Do I want green tea as a keyword, which I could see that the average monthly search is quite high? So should I look for this, or should I look for a low one where the competition is low, where the competition is let's say less than 0.5 or 0.4, 0.3? So should I focus around that, or should I not focus around that? So I select on basis of that. I select that, like for example, it's a medium kind of thing. So I can select this, I can select this. So you're doing a filtration process, right? So organic green tea, it is very high competitive, but you could see the searches are low. To some extent, even the bidding price is also a good reflection of what you should do, you should not do, right? So there are people who are also searching what is green tea, the people who are searching green tea leaves. So you could have various mechanisms of selecting it. So if you being into this position, can you just let me know, Ento and Harish and Santosh and Sanjeet, what kind of keyword you look, a high competitive keyword or a low competitive keyword, a keyword with high monthly average you should be looking for it, or a low. What will be your way of doing it? Sanjeet, you can ask this question from the organizers, please. And to say it's low, you're saying search which is low competitive, right? People who are not making high searches on that. Harish says medium. Harish, you can reply on the public thing rather than privately replying it to me. And to say yes. Starter. Sanjeet says I've just entered. Alright, Sanjeet. In a search engine optimization, Sanjeet, we are taking the first sub-product of it. We are taking first step that in order to have whatever pages you have in command in your website, you are basically selecting what could be the focal keywords you want them to be searched, optimized for. In order to do that, you could list down few, there will be anyways few keywords into your mind, and then there will be few keywords you could ask from the prospective customer in order to gauge the what kind of efficiency those keywords have. You could use a tool called Google Keyword Planner tool, which is available inside a Google AdWords account. So there we are making use of it, and we are selecting out of the list of, when you search for green tea or tea, we got these 800 keywords related to that. Now based on their low or medium competitiveness, what kind of average search they have, yes, for this particular page, when we list down every page on the website which we want to search optimize for, and we'll write focal keywords and we'll select that. So I'm giving a quoting right now for a green color. I'm selecting 1 to 3 pages keywords for that. Santosh is low and medium. All right. See, the first, now it is very subjective, and for a good optimization, of course, we should focus on low and medium. But I frankly differ with the industry on this. My idea is a little different. I would, out of those three keywords which I choose, I always want to have one very high competitive and very high average monthly search keyword into my kitty. Now don't take it as my heart, don't take it as a pure suggestion. It is my personal view of reflecting it. The reason why I'm saying this is, search engine optimization is not a paid search, right? And let's say you are a new brand, you started new. Search engine optimization is gonna take a hell lot of effort. It's a long-term effort, but once it gains its momentum, it will be there for, you know, for a longer period of time. Now, in order to have that, why to ignore a high searched keyword? Because at the end of the day, that's the keyword which is actually being searched far more. Like for example, green tea over here. So according to you, I should ignore it. I should not consider green tea right now. So I should basically do it white. I should not select it. But I say that since I'll be using 1, 2, and 3 keywords for this particular page, I know that my results will not be that faster, Santosh and Anto, which yours be if I choose green tea as a focal keyword, because it's very high competitive, it's 0.95, and it's quite high being searched for, so I will not get a faster result. You may be able to optimize this page in, let's say, 2 months or 3 months time. I may take 6 months, 7 months. But at the end of the day, this is not something which I'm spending money for every click. It's quite organic way of doing it. Even the expense related to that will be limited to the human resource only. But I should not ignore it, because at the end of the day, audience search for it, right? So I would always recommend not to, my personal view is I should not ignore high competitive keywords at all, because at the end of the day, these are the keywords which are searched for. So I should have a great mix of low, medium and high, but I should not completely ignore high. So you may differ with me on this, or you may agree to, right? Santosh, Harish, Swapnil has, I guess, recently joined us,
right, sir?
So say yes. Harish, you can reply on public rather than replying me in private. So anyways, clear till here? So let's say, for example, we have picked this page. Now we have to pick another page. I'm just writing down a few keywords over here. So let's say I've selected, for example, I've selected this keyword one, green tea. What to select is entirely your prerogative, right? Just for to make things faster, I'm just selecting these three keywords at random, but I'm not suggesting that these are the only three keywords which you suggest for. You should look for low competitive as well, or whatever you feel should be selecting. So this way, what you're doing is, for this particular page, you selected these three keywords, and same way you're going to repeat this task for every page, including home page, right? So if I go with onto the home page, so I list down all my 15-20 pages which I have, and let's say for this I'm giving yellow color, and this is the keyword which I want as a focal keyword for this. And same way, when I do for black, I'll make focal keyword choice around that page which I made for. Let's say white tea is one of the page, or jasmine tea is one of the page, and whatever, or any merchandise which is related to tea, like teapot and all that, right? Whatever if you're offering. What you're doing right now is you're optimizing your website, which is nothing but summation of web pages. So you're selecting pages one by one. Let's say if I go to this page, and for this page I select those 2 to 3 keywords which I want as when somebody lands on this page, I want people to land on this page, and this page should come as a organic result what is being searched for. What are those keywords it is searched for? This I'm selecting from here. So this part till here, A to G, H is only for reference. This is the main thing which you'll be working. Like for example, for this particular URL, these are the three keywords which are green tea benefits, and benefits of green tea. So you'll be, so this way you can select those keywords. And same way you do it for every page. And once you see, you start building it, you have made it for the whole website. For every page, you have chosen 2 to 3 focal keywords which you want to do it. How you get the keywords of a particular URL? No, I didn't get you. We have just mentioned URL over here, Sanjeet, and we have chosen keyword which we feel that to optimize this URL, we should be focusing around these three keywords. So we have just selected and we've written down in front of it. Right? You're asking how do we get these keywords? Okay, this is the result of you coming late. If you could have come on time, you would have known. But anyway, Sanjeet, these are the keywords. No, it's okay. I'll let you know. No problem. See, in order to optimize your page, let me make you understand this way. This is your website, right? It is nothing but summation of web pages. And Sanjeet, I really want you to be prompting yes or no quite often, because I'm talking one-on-one with you right now, right? Now this is the website we are promoting. It's an e-commerce website. I've taken as an example. It is a website of one of the batchmate of yours. Now, since we have selected it, a website is nothing but summation of these URLs, these pages, right? And it has various pages. This is one page. That is another page. Now, a search engine optimization is nothing but what you are doing on the page. It is divided in on page and off page. I'll differentiate you once we'll cover on going forward. But an on page optimization is basically you're making your content so efficient that when you write down a query, show up name sales. Can you hear me now, Fritz? Sanjeet, Swapnil, please just hold on, guys. Okay, so now what you want is, if somebody goes to Google, and type a particular keyword, you want your page, Swapnil, you can go to the admin, call them and solve your query. I'm only trainer over here, this is not my responsibility. Anyways, so let's say the owner of this website wants, if somebody search for green tea or any word which is related to green tea weight loss or green tea price, anything, my result should come over here as an organic result. Like health card is coming or Amazon coming. even I should get as a result. Now look into the different perspectives, Sanjit, you will find wait, Swapnil is trying to say something. What kind of help you want? Are you able to listen to me, Swapnil, right now? Can you hear me? Swapnil, can you hear me? I guess not. So, Sanjit and others, please look onto the different perspective that I have a website over here, which is summation of web pages. And I want if somebody search for, let's say, black tea or anything related to black tea, then my this black tea page should come as an organic result. But in also in order to something around black tea, there are many keywords, right? So the idea is you should select at least one, two or three keywords, make it as a focal keyword and make your page so optimized that if it has been searched for keywords which is related to that, those three focal keywords, then my result should come onto the top. Now in order to have that, what should be that focal keyword? The question is what should be that focal keyword, that precise keyword which I should, you know, make it as focus keyword. In order to have that, the first thing which you can do is it will automatically comes into your mind as gut feel that these are the keywords I should be, you know, which could be in my radar. The second step is I can go to the primary audience, the prospective primary buyers, and I can just, all right, fine. The second thing is I can go to those prospective buyers or my peer group and friends and, you know, people in the industry and somehow make that list. But in order to have that scientifically, you know, believed onto this website, onto that list, as well as choosing scientifically, there is one tool which is called Keyword Planner tool. Now it gives me an idea. If I search for that particular keyword, it will give me a list of whole lot of keywords accord with their average monthly searches, you know, and the competition and all that. How to get into that was exactly Sanjit's question. So in order to have that, you need to have a Google AdWords account. This Keyword Planner tool will help you also in search engine optimization as well as in the paid activity of Google AdWords while we'll be making ads for that. So in navigation bar, you need to go to tools and you have to click on Keyword Planner. For all those who have joined a little after, we have covered this, how to reach to the list. I'm just letting you know. And here you write down the keyword. You can write down tea, green tea, whatever you want to do it. Right? So you write down your keyword. You select your target audience. You can also localize. For example, you only want to know the search of Delhi NCR and you know what is the search happening in Delhi NCR, because that is your field area, that is your market area for your product. So you can do that. You want to cater to India, you can do that. You want to cater to any other nation, you can do that. So you can select your location basically from here, and then you need to just click on get ideas. So it will help you in getting those ideas, and you'll get this way. Here you select keyword ideas. And this is the list which you got. You can click on download and you will get an Excel sheet like this. And here, the next thing which you do is out of these keywords, based on your subjective view, you select for particular URL what should be those keywords. So everybody clear till here? A double clear till here? How to achieve this? Harish says yes. Chitranshi, did you got it? Neha? Swapnil? Santosh? Sanjeet, you got it? Prabodhan? Prabodhan, I'm waiting for your reply. Did you got it? Yes. Alright. Now comes another major part. Let's say this is the page. For example, I want to promote it. So what I've done is, अभी मैंने ingredients prepare कर लिए अपनी dish के लिए. Now I'll start cooking it. So I've done chopping. I've selected the vegetables I want to do. I've washed it. I've selected. So I've selected keywords now. वहाँ तक काम हो गया. Now I'll fire the burner and start cooking it. How to do that? For those who are very doing it for the first time may get a little strange of whatever we have opened right now. This is nothing, friends. It is very easy. In fact, if you enroll, you will also get this kind of panel. This is the front end of a site called nickelgrover.com. This could be any site, right? Now, how this site has been made? This site could be made by a developer, or this site could be made by a CMS, a content management system, where people who are not developer, who doesn't know coding, people like you and me, can also create a site and manage a site. So this is the front end of that site. It has been made on a WordPress. This is the back end of the site. It may look a little confusing, but it is very easy. So on left hand side, you have a panel where you can add new pages onto the website, add new posts onto the website, right? Name the URL, name the title of the page, add an image into the page, select a slider, select your theme and all that, right? So let's say this is the page I want to optimize it. So there are various plugins. So you write your content and then you go to plugins. And you go to add new plugin. There is a very, very, very efficient and very, very short for plugin called Yoast WordPress SEO by Yoast. So you can search for this. For me, it will already come as installed. So it is coming as installed because I've already installed it. For you, it will be coming as installed now. So you can just install it. Once you install it, it will come as a new section over here. SEO, right? And for every page you make, like for example here, let's say this page, beneath every page you will get a reference thing by Yoast SEO. So here you can make the changes and it'll let you know that are you know, doing it right or not doing it right. So here you could see various attributes. Now what are these attributes? We'll learn now. Now look onto this site. When again, please guys, don't take it literally, take it metaphorically. When Shah Rukh Khan says that my name is Khan and I'm not a terrorist, by saying my name is Khan, he's trying to give it a meta tag with a title. If somebody search for it, this is the name it want to associate with. And I'm not a terrorist as it's basically describing itself, right? So if you go for a okay, it was anyways open. So let's look onto this organic result. This is what? Can anybody tell me this green tea, buy green tea, this blue color? This is? This is meta title, right? This herbal tea, organic, this is meta description. So these are the tags, right? And this is URL. Got it? This one is meta title. This one is meta description. And this one is URL. Now this is meta title, this is URL, and this is meta description. Now in order to make this page optimized, first I need to type down what focal keyword I'm looking for. So here what keyword I'll type, those keywords which are selected via keyword planner tool thing, right? So for this page, that was a different example, this is a different example. So let's say I'm focusing on Nikhil Grover. That is my keyword, right? So I write down focal keyword. This focal keyword now should be part of your meta title, should also be part of your URL, and should also be inclusive in the meta description. Now if you go and edit and write down the meta description. If you don't write it, it will pick the content from the it will pick from the content only, from the few lines of your pages only. But I'll request to edit it and write down and include the focal keyword over here, right? And also check on the various recommendations it is making. It is saying that the text contains 91 words. This is far too low. So for a page, it should have at least more than 300, 400, 500 odd words. In fact, for the blog post, it will recommend more than 800, 900 words. So what it is asking me is that you should go and you should write down a good number of content over here. So this is, I should do, I'm just randomly writing it. But this is how I should do. So I should write down a great content over here. So there are few posts which I've already, few pages which I've already optimized it. So I'll go to that page. You could see that it's a big article written. Now there is one error which is, or one recommendation it is saying, if it has been fulfilled it would be red. So it is saying the focal keyword YO does not appear on the page title. So if I go into the content, here is the page title which I have not written. Page title over here. And you could see now that thing has gone, right? So we are optimizing our page, we are making our page so much efficient. So for this keyword, my signal is coming green. Have I this on the meta title? Yes, I have. I have this on the this keyword on the URL. I have. Do I have that on the meta description? Yes, I have. What are the other recommendations? All these. It will also request you to. I'll also request you to have few external links onto the page. So you more external links is considered as more savvy towards search engine optimization. Put images, right? We'll cover this all things one by one. So up clear up till here about meta description. Right, let us also all right, what are heading tags? So amongst tag we have a title tag, we have a description, meta description tag. What are heading tags? Heading tags are basically this. So you write down a heading. So amongst and in heading tag also, it is recommended that you should include the focal keyword. So you're putting heading over here. So this is heading tag. Right? So this way you optimize it. The more you practice it, the more you'll get to know about it. So this plugin will help you out a great deal while making a content, adding a content, you know, putting a description, putting up a URL. You can also change the URL. You can go over here, edit, and write down a URL. So my URL includes YO. You can also remove it and only write YO. So it's up to you when you want to do that, right? You should have images. How to add an image? You add media. It could be onto your library, or you can upload and browse from your computer and put up an image. So whatever image you're gonna put, this is called this alt tags. What are alt tags? An image is an alt tag. So for example, if I want this image as an alt text, I can write down its name. So whenever it search for YO as an image, search engine will search this image. So I'm making it optimized for this. So it will come as alt tags. Right? So never leave this empty. Put your keyword over here for whatever image you are putting in the content. So for an example of T, for every image which you are uploading onto this, write down the name of the image in your e-commerce site, if in case you are promoting an e-commerce site, with an alt text of that focal keyword you are doing it. So you are not only putting on a meta description and the title page, you are also putting focal keyword around your images in order to have a greater search. Okay. Got it, friends? Everything clear till here? What is the recommended length of title tag? Can anybody tell me that? Santosh, can you tell me that? Yes, it should be between 50 to 60. Yes, max is 60, but it should be ideally around 50, 55, 56. Anything between 50 to 60. And for description, Santosh? Yes, 160. And it should be ideally around 140 and above. 140, 150. Again, it is recommended around 150. But here this plugin will, if you write down more than, let's say you cross 160 and all that, it become red and it will highlight you that, you know, you're going overboard. So these are the plugins which help you in order to have that. All right. Now there is an anchor text, concept of anchor text and cross linking. What is anchor text? Can anybody tell me what is anchor text? If I go onto this site, example of punchline to be used for writing. Yes, see, basically your meta description should have first of all a focus keyword so that it becomes search savvy, and second, what could be the possible outcomes which a user expect, the prices, you know, some catchy line like you are referring to punchlines, so you can use that. Now if you see onto this website, on this page, Neha, you're clear? Shall I move ahead? But just referring your thing, you want examples, but see, punchline is basically for promoting it onto the display network, right? Not onto the SEO part of it. This is more of a marketing activity which should be taken a leverage when you're doing it on the various facets, which includes a display network, a display orientation. Whereas going here on the meta description, you should focus around your focal keyword and the activities which could be catchy enough for a user. Like for example, a good price mechanism you have put, you know, various attributes of products which you are putting. So use it to that reference rather than putting only as a punchline. Anyway, I'm moving ahead. Now if you see, this is a text written over here, Nikhil Grover, allow me to tell you something. But I can't click that. If I go over there, it is not clickable, right? But this home is clickable. or if I move ahead, these are clickable. Now anything which is clickable and clicked and takes you to another page, another landing page, this particular text, a Milky Way for Coca-Cola, it becomes an anchor text, right? So into your content, you could take the advantage of anchor text. So you can select this and link it internally as well as externally. So if you make it land to another page of nikhilgrover.com/another page, then it becomes an internal link. And if you link it to a page which is not which does not have a domain name nikhilgrover.com but have any other external domain of any site which is, let's say, related to any one of you, then it becomes an external link. The more external link, the better, because even you should get high and high of external links that will cover enough page optimization. So that is called anchor text, the text which you are selected and making it land to while clicking on it, making it land to another page, right? So there is a concept of anchor text. Everybody clear till here? Then we're gonna cover broken link. Sanjeev says yes. Naresh, Prabodhan, Santosh, Swapnil, Anto, Chitranshi. Alright. Now what happens is, sometimes in your website there are so many pages, you know, there are so many activities going around, and sometimes this anchor link, clicking on something, it doesn't land to the desired page, and it's a broken link which comes. The more broken links, the bad is for your website, right? Its rating, its ranking goes down because it is not working efficiently, and people are facing problem of broken links. In order to regularly check that, you can do it with brokenlinkcheck.com. So what you can do is, and there are various other broken link sites to check these links. So you can just write down, let's say for example I put pahadit.com, right? Since it has many pages, pahadit.com, find for broken link. It's asking for captcha. M7GGN. So it will take some time to process all the web pages and find out if there is any broken link in it. So that way you can do and check it out if in case you have any broken link onto the website, and if in case you have that, rectify it and, you know, go to the developer of your website and somehow tackle it out. So it takes some time to check out the pages. Since it is doing that, everybody clear till here? No problem. sometimes there could be some issues with the development. Your developer may have missed a few coding statements where the link has an form. So that could be one of the reasons. Sometimes you have, in a quick mechanism, do not have put a correct URL onto the anchor text. So for example, you have selected the anchor text right while writing down a URL to which it should land. You may have missed a correct URL, and then it becomes a broken link because there is no such landing page which you have put. So this could be one of the reasons how it comes. But anyways, it is taking a little more time because it has quite a good number of pages. So what happens is it gives us a status report, and it is going to give us that these are the pages where there is broken link, if in case there will be any, and there is high possibility that there won't be any. So once you get to the pages that these are the broken links, that you can rectify it, right? In the meanwhile, we'll cover other topics and let it go, let it function, that will come back to it. And we are on to the final few topics. Robot.txt. Now this is, Antoine initially asked me this. What happens in a search engine, for your website, you have a robot file into your website. Now it works as an instructor basically to the search engine, that once any query is searched for a search engine, these are the pages I want you to be searched amongst my website, and these are the pages I do not want to be searched, right? So what you do is, let's say I'm taking robot.txt, and this is how you're gonna get this page, a node, that kind of page, where you write down users/agent, asterisk, crawl delay, and if in case I want, let's say I do not want a particular page for website to search it, or for search engine to search it and reflect it as a search, then I can write it down over here. As disallow / the URL of the thing, right? So I can write down the page. Let's say for example, I do not want it to search for about us page. So I can write down. So what happens is, when search engine searches for it, as an instructor, a robot.txt file, I've instructed the search engine not to consider this page while searching. But the question is, why would I do that? Why would I mention few particular pages amongst my website not to be searched? Can anyone answer that? Santosh, Sandeep, Chitranchi, Anto. Anto, you know the answer, so you just hold on for a while. Neha. So by robot.txt, I write it down and I put it onto the robot.txt file of my website, and I'm saying that I'm instructing the search engine not to search for this particular page. Can anybody respond to me that why I would not want any particular page to be looked for when it is being searched for? It should not come as a search result. Can anybody give me an example of what kind of pages I should, you know, hold myself not to? Neha, Sanjeev, Santosh, like for example, yours is an e-commerce site and there is a payment page over there, right? So you would not want your users' payment information, credit card information to be easily searchable, right? So you want it under the privacy ground, you do not want that. On the registration page, you do not want where there is password being failed, you do not want that to be looked for. So in robot.txt, it's a file which is there into the backend of your website where you're instructing your search engines that these are the pages which I'm disallowing you not to look for when you're searching onto the website. Got it? Neha, Santosh, Swapnil. And this is the way you do it. Chitranshi. Yes, you can. And then this is the last concept of sitemap.xml. It basically gives you the whole tree of your, let us check in the meanwhile, it is still processing, so we'll come back to it. So if you open this sitemap, it gives you a whole tree of, you know, how the website is structured. So it basically helps search engine to search it out. So let's say I'm doing this. Authority, let's start this. Oh, some error has occurred. Let's say if it does for nickelgrover.com. Okay, the local link is not clear. I'll just clear you now. Let us cover this and I'll get back to you on this. So you can download the sitemap and give it to your developer and ask them to put it onto the website backend. Now what happens is a sitemap basically helps, it is nothing but a tree, what is link is there beneath another link and it makes a whole structure. This helps the search engine to look for the particular content onto your website. Now this is one. Now broken link, I'm coming back again on broken link. Let's say I'm on this site. For example, let's say mapdeal.com/ you see, there is no page like this. So let's assume that this is some page which was there in the website and I clicked on that and this is how I landed up in a page where, you know, it doesn't amount to any significance significant importance of the page. So there is no page as such. So let's say, for example, I'll give you another example. I go to nikhilgrover.com. Okay, I'll try to make a broken link for you. While putting a content, I try to link it to any other site. Let's say I try to put it into dmppaathshala.com. So I selected this link. And I selected this and I've updated it. So what happens is, if somebody clicks on that, it will land to a page called DMP Paathshala. And let's say I've selected another page, another link. I'm giving you both examples. And I've selected www.dmp. And in a hurry to put that, I've only selected this. And I add link. And I updated the page. Now when I go onto the front end of the site, I could see this article and I could see that there are two external links coming over here. If I click this, let's see what happens. If I click this, I was landed to a page. So this link is working fine. It is not a broken link. And let's see what happens if I click this. Okay, there is one site called DMP. Anyways, we have to take another example for this. Let's say by mistake I put a link which was not correct, right? And let's see what happens on the front end side. If I click on this, it won't land me to any page, right? So it's a broken link, right? The more broken links in your website, the bad your ranking will be in a search engine optimization, right? So you're basically not doing a good work onto the content management system, onto the website management system, onto the search and optimization for your page, right? So in order to see, right now this website is only a few pages, or once you start building your website, it will be of a few pages, and then pages will gradually keep on adding. But once it will be a functional website, you will be surprised to know that there will be many, many pages into your website. And if it's an e-commerce, there will be a hell lot of pages into that. Now, how you're going to find every link that it is working or not? So there is a tool which you could find in this, like brokenlinkcheck.com or sites related to that. You just put down your site name, and it will fetch a broken link for you. Like for example, over here, while we were searching for part80.com, we could find that this particular URL is not working properly. So if somebody clicks on this URL, it will not land to this page. So you go to your developer if in case you made it, or if it's on a CMS, check out what kind of problem is there and rectify it, that this should land to a landing page. Clear, Neha? Chitranchi, Anto, Harish. Everybody clear till here? Santosh, Swapnil. So search engine optimization is not very difficult. We have covered one part of it. We have covered an on-page optimization. Like for example, if we have website, we have many pages in our website. How do we make it optimized? How we make it efficient within our page so that it becomes search savvy? Now, like I said in the starting, again same, I've given you the example. You just go to this site. There are various examples, but this is one of the good sites you can refer for, xmlsitemaps.com, and you can just put down, like a broken link, you have put down the URL, just put down your URL and then you'll get it, and you can then download the sitemap.xml from there. Now I was saying that there are two ways a search engine optimization, on page and off page. To define it on a easy terms, on a very very easy terms, I define it in a way of, if you have to promote a web page or a website which is nothing but summation of web pages, there are only two ways you can do it. A, you make it efficient, which is on page, and you make it popular, which is off page. So what I mean by that popular, we'll cover that once we cover off page optimization. But in general terms, you can just refer it as that there are people who are recommending you. So the more recommendations, the more backlinks, the more weightage that you have been voted more into the search engine domain, that you have been voted more, and there are people who are looking to land into your website, and you're getting traffic from other websites, right? So, and this is very common rule which applies generally also, right? How do anybody become searchable? कोई ज़्यादा किसी के लिए ऑडियंस ज़्यादा क्यों जाएगी किसी उसके लिए? A, he is efficient, that you are getting the content what you wanted, and B, you are popular, so you will ultimately land up yourself onto the top of organic listing. Clear? Any other question related to this or any aspect of digital marketing? Because there are I could see many new names coming on right now. So that could be, you may have missed. Don't worry, this is nothing. We'll cover that. I'll let you know in the following sessions. So don't be afraid. Go a little slow, right? Now, okay, Sanjeev is asking. Yes, Neha. Meanwhile, I'm answering Sanjeev. How the competitive is measured? You're asking for competition in keyword, right? Over here. Google has an algorithm for one particular keyword, Sanjeet. There are various bids which is happening real time, right? And there are various searches which is happening around that time. So Google makes it onto the standard that how many searches are happening, and based on that it gives a competitive rating. So if a keyword is searched more respect to the audience who are putting it up, it will become a high competitive word. If there are low keyword searches which is happening for that, becomes a low key. So it basically depends on what, like for example, there are five people who are competing for one particular keyword, and there are 500 people who are competing for one particular keyword. So the 500 one wala will become more competitive than the one which is for five for that particular keyword. So this is how they determine that which keyword is more competitive and which is less competitive. this will cover. See, you'll get confused if I'll pick one topic out of one subtopic out of the whole domain. You'll get confused. You're not going to get everything on one. We'll cover Google AdWords as a separate session. It is divided into two sessions. So once we cover that, we'll cover suggested bid, how to have the suggested bid, what should be the bandwidth of the suggested bid, what are the various attributes related to suggested bid. We'll cover everything in detail, so don't worry about that. That will be part of a paid result. This is, right now we're covering non-paid part of it. Suppose, sir, I've already made a website of 500 pages and I want to train. I have to change in. No, I didn't get you. You have made a website of 500 pages and you want to change in link. What do you want to change in bulk in those 500 pages? What exactly you want to change? Okay, so you basically have 500 pages and you started optimizing, you have optimized those 500 pages, and now you want, let's say you want to change keywords for all those 500 pages at one go, at bulk, and you are finding that the SEO is not happening right and you want to change it, right? Santosh, this is your question, right? I got your question, I guess. Yeah, as per my knowledge, I do not have that because it goes page wise. And as per my understanding, it should not be there because at one go you will be able to change all the, but any developer can make that for you if in case he is making a customized site. With regards to CMS, I have doubt that they probably will have that. They may have also had that. So I need to search it down various plugins and talk to a few developers if in case that can be done. But into my capacity, right now I do not have the answer for that. Maybe it doesn't have that because you basically do it for every page. So how you're going to do it? Or there could be a tool where, you know, in the database, wherever the focal keywords are written down, it can be changed at once for all. There is the possibility. I do not deny that. And there could be existing plugins also. But I've never practiced that, so I have no knowledge about that right now. I'll try to get back to you on that. Alright, so what I'm doing, friends, right now, we're more or less covered with the topic for today. This is the feedback link. Now, all of you have to fill this along with the comments. Do not only give ratings, but do fill comments also because that helps me in shaping the future sections and let me know what changes could we bring for better. So please go to these feedback links, give a feedback, write down a comment. And then once you're done, just let me know that you're done. You can write down done in the chatting. So I'll come to know that you're done. I guess you guys are filling the feedback link. Please fill the feedback link. Also, this is a link where you can check out the videos. I've been told for all who have already enrolled in will be able to check all the videos. So whatever we are discussing in this session, it is getting recorded and it will be uploaded onto this link. The administration of DMP does that. I'm only discharging duties as a trainer, so I'll pass on and they'll upload it, I guess, very shortly. For all those who are on a demo, we'll have a limited access towards those videos. So you can just go to that link and check it out. Sanjeet says done. Thank you, Sanjeet. So Sanjeet, this is, I'm sorry, I just missed. I probably would have asked you earlier also. Was this your first session or? Hare says thanks. Thank you. Okay, nice. So what was the first session which you have covered, Sanjeet? Thank you, Anto. Anto, you will be there in the evening session also, right? Today in the evening session, which is a batch which are already covered 7-8 sessions. There will be covering Google AdWords part 2. So for all those who have the capacity of not getting confused, can come to this session as well. Thank you. Thanks, Prabodhan. Thank you, Neha. Thanks. Thanks, Sanjeet. Thank you. So all who are done can leave, no problem. I'll be just waiting for the last one to return and leave. So for all those who have done, the feedback can leave. Next time we'll be covering friends, part 2, SEO part 2. So Swapnil, the session will start at 8:30. So it will be an 8:30 to 10:30 session. We'll be going to cover Google AdWords part 2. So part 1 is already covered. So you may find it a little difficult to grasp. But if you find it difficult, then you may even leave it in between. Don't overstress yourself. Yeah. So once we'll cover Google AdWords in this batch, then you can cover it. Yeah. All right, friends. So, yeah, Swapnil, you can. You can check out onto the last, there will be, see, on the video link, I'm sharing it again. Let us do it this way because you can check out on the introductory session of mine and while going on to this link. There will be various basic introductory sessions over there. So you can check out through that link. And if in case you are again finding some difficulty or want to have it, just let me know. Try to accommodate it in any of the batch so that you will get that. This is not the introductory, frankly, guys. We have already covered 2-3 sessions. And for any doubts, too, this is my number. I only discharge duties as an trainer. So anything, any of your query which is related to admin oriented, like when are the batches, what are the course material, and all that, and all that. What is the fees and all that. So for that you can contact onto the number which you can see onto the screen, the DMP admin number. This is the number. Yeah. So anything which is related to the subject matter, yes, I'll be there. All right, submit. So thank you. Thanks. I guess time to go. Let us see you next week, and if in case you will be coming in the evening session, let's see you in the evening session. Yeah, bye bye.